This is a pretty happy day at Orange United Church. My name is Karen McSpadden, and it's my pleasure to welcome you, and I will be doing a few announcements. You might be curious why I would have the honor of stepping up here first, but maybe you don't know that we share a minister, our minister Janice Pow. We share her with KTV, which is a little church about 10 miles east of here. So we always get the ball rolling here, and she'll be coming through the back door very shortly. Typically, we like to start our morning with an acknowledgement, a land acknowledgement. And so you might be interested to know just why we are doing this. Acknowledging the territory on which we are gathering and the people who have traditionally called it home for thousands of years is a way to continue to live out the church's apology to the first persons of North America. We acknowledge that this land, where we have gathered to worship for over 200 years, was previously inhabited for generations by indigenous people. We also acknowledge the enduring presence and deep traditional knowledge, laws, and philosophies of the first people with whom we share this land today. We are all treaty people with a responsibility to honor all of our relations with the promise and challenge of truth and reconciliation. Now, I hope as you came in, you noticed our motto over the front door, which is open doors, open hearts, celebrating God's love. And that is what we are striving to do and be here today. The first Sunday of the month, any month around here, is always coffee hour. And so I want to invite each and every one of you to come on downstairs after the service if you're able and if you wish to, and join us for some refreshment and conversation. And of course, the fact that it is June means that this is Pride Month. And this is something that we celebrate across Ontario, across Canada, around the world, and so we're celebrating it here too. A few announcements, but frankly, the announcements are included in the bulletin. People get the announcements. You probably are pretty much up to speed. But this Monday, because it is the first Monday of the month, our church council meets by Zoom, still meeting by Zoom, to make our reports and so forth. And it also happens to be the first Monday of the month. So that's the day that we celebrate Messy Church, which is a program for kids and their parents and grandparents who come here at 4:30 in the afternoon. They have stories, a little bit of singing, some crafts, and they always have dinner together. I know this week the menu is hot dogs, and I also know that there's going to be birthday cake because they're celebrating Pentecost, and Pentecost marks the birthday of our church. So if you know any little ones who would be interested in participating in this, doors are wide open. We'd love to see you. Downstairs at the lower hall, it starts at 4:30. There are other announcements, but I think the other one that I picked out that I thought was kind of important is the fact that next Sunday, every Sunday in June, we have something special going on at North United Church. Next Sunday is going to be Camping Sunday. And North United Church has run a summer camp here for like 16 or 17 years, six different themes over the weeks. We have wonderful young people leading the camps. So next Sunday is what we call Camping Sunday. And the young people who have been hired to run the camps and supervise will be part of our service. We do a kind of a recognition and just show our support for their work in the church. We will have the donation of a beautiful piece of stained glass. Usually there's a beautiful piece of stained glass here because that's one of the activities at one of the art camps. You saw it, you know it was there. And so that will be recognized and appreciated in the church. And then there's also going to be lunch next week. Next week, lunch is going to be pizza, and that's something that is a lunch that we run in support of mission and services. So any funds that come from your piece of pizza will go to the work of mission service, which is part of our work here at North United Church. Yes, you should just check your bulletin. There are lots of announcements. We're all happy to send you e-announcements if you're interested. I guess one announcement that didn't make it into the bulletin this week, because frankly we were just a little slow getting it off the press, and we're calling it, It Takes a Village to get a flagpole in place. So I hope you noticed that we do have a flagpole with a flag flying today, and that's very new as of the beginning of June. Dan Cahoe would like to acknowledge the remarkable support of Mike Clover at Titan Trailers in Portland, who donated the very tall, straight, and lightweight aluminum pole to fly our flags outside Norwich United Church. Andrew Malcolm was useful in helping to source the very large solid stone that we'll use to anchor the flag firmly in place. Special thanks also to Tim Christo and Randy Knobs, who took the time and had the equipment to place it perfectly in front of our sign at the sidewalk. Glenn Stone was there to help Dan with drilling, smoothing, and finishing the pole and its attachments, as well as in drilling the anchors into the rock. Chris and Kevin Avey helped with the final stages to attach the progress flag and put the pole on in support. See what I mean? It takes the village. So thanks to everyone who helped with this project. Final word of welcome. I know that there are some people here for whom it may be the first time they've come to Norwich United Church. We want you to feel so welcome, and we'll do everything we can to kind of talk you through this if any of this seems a little strange. When we were preparing for this, I came across the guest book, which was a common feature. I found it down in the library, and it was, you know, a little bit dusty and cobwebs, because the guest book hasn't been out since before COVID. So it was a pleasure to turn to a brand new page and write 2023. And if you happen to be a person who'd be willing to sign the guest book, it's at the back, and it's just a bit of a memento of this day. We'd love you to sign it if you feel comfortable doing that. And then there's the business of how do you know when to rise, how do you know when to sit down. If you are able, you should keep an eye on the choir. We typically are rehearsed and sort of know what we're doing. So if we stand up and you're able, you stand up and join us, and there will be singing and there will be celebration. And there's Janice Pow just coming in now. So I have one more thing. Oh, I was also going to mention for any children who are here today, we love to see you here. We have a number of activities and so forth at the back of the church and coloring materials and so forth that you can use if you're interested. If you want to go downstairs, you are most welcome to go down. We actually have everybody wanting to be upstairs in the service today. So if anybody feels like they need to take a walk, just be comfortable. Get up, go on downstairs. There's a washroom just inside the front door if you need to use that. So just please feel welcome and comfortable here. There's nothing you can do that will disturb us, honestly. We like it better if it gets a little bit rowdy and we hear kids' voices. Okay. That pretty much takes care of what I need to say. And there's one more thing I get to do here before I go up to the choir loft, because that's one of my other jobs. And that is we take a time now to share any joys or concerns that anyone might have and would like to share. And I just kind of walk around with this microphone and you get to tell us what you're thinking about and what's important in your life, if you choose to do that. Do I have anyone who would like the microphone? Okay, hold on.
Good morning. I have sad news and I have the good news. The sad news is that Julia Ferris had a stroke on Thursday night. At 8 o'clock, she's in Brentford Hospital. The way it looks, I think she's one of the lucky ones. She can still move her leg and her arm, and her speech is slowly coming back too. So keep her in our prayers that that she will recover 100%. Okay, and then we have another one. Rosie's birthday is today. Rosie's birthday. I'm not saying how old you are. And we have another one. Karen's was on Wednesday. And I think it's time to have them happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Rosie. Troy, our friend of March United and the community here, Julie Fiche, donated 50 of these progress flags. So thank you very much, Julie, for supporting NUC and Pride Sunday today.
And everybody's supposed to be sure to take one if you'd like one. We think we've got enough to go around. Anybody else have something they'd like to share? It sure is nice to see you all here. Oh, here's someone.
I'm a member of St. David's United Church in Woodstock, and I would really like to thank you for welcoming us to your service today. Unfortunately, St. David's as yet is not a church that is totally welcoming to gay and lesbian, etc., community, but we're very happy to be here on this Pride Sunday. So thank you very much.
Thank you. I think we will just turn it over to you now, Janice.
Yay, I got one more thing to do. Dig out my glasses and I'll be all on board. I just want to welcome everyone. Get my, 1 second. Yeah, here I am. Okay, welcome. It is so amazing. Look at everybody, this is so cool. I'm so nervous. I want to, you know, you practice when you have nobody in the house and you preach and maybe you give the best sermon you ever had and you're so, yippee! Now I got everybody here including cameras and I'm gonna blow it for sure. But what we need to remember that it's not about me. It's not even about us, it's about God, it's about love and celebrating who we are and who God created us to be and the freedom to embrace all of that. So these pride flags, maybe, I don't know if any of you have even been in church before, and if you haven't, welcome. You're going to like it. You know on TV when they go all men or they raise the roof, they're going to do all men and wave the flags. So when you say something, when something is said that you like or you agree, wave the flag and you do an all men.
Amen.
Okay, come on. Love for everybody. All men. Woo! Love! Alright. So be with me and be patient. I'm going to hopefully, I heard that Karen talked about when to stand up, when to sit down. We'll explain different parts of the service. Have we done the land acknowledgement?
Yes.
So we're ready, are we ready for the intro? Yeah. This is kind of like a musical coming together. It's like the bells, like the lights flashing in the theater. It's time to get to your seat. So this is the intro.
The blues are out, Elizabeth.
So anytime it's blue, it's your turn to talk. All right? So we, okay, so our call to worship. We are an amazing, talented, fabulous, diverse group of people. We are one body in Christ, beloved and blessed. In faithfulness, let us offer ourselves during this time of worship. And we light this candle remembering that God created the light, the Savior's love, the light, and the Spirit offers us the fire to stir us from complacency. And opening prayer. So this is just what it says. It's just a time of prayer. Loving God, you teach us to love outrageously. In the fullness of our being, we seek to live mercy. Encourage us to include all brothers, sisters, and siblings as your beloved. May our love be all-encompassing. We commit ourselves to your radical way of devotion. Amen. And our opening hymn today is Let's Build a House. It's found in More Voices, number 1. And we're singing verses 1, 4, and 5. And not to worry, the words will all be up on the screen. And if you are able, we'd like you to stand. If you're not comfortable standing, stay seated. If you're tired, stay seated. But if you want to sing or embrace the words or just embrace the spirit of what's happening, stand up and let the spirit move and let the spirit come out in voice. Let us build a house.
Thank you.
Let this house proclaim from floor to rafter, all are welcome. All are welcome. All are welcomed in this space. Hallelujah. Amen. Wait. And now we come to the prayer of confession. This is a time when we confess not only personally, but for the community and our part within that. And it is a prayer said in unison, and not to be afraid. If you don't feel comfortable saying the words, you don't have to. But it's not a personal prayer, it's a community prayer. Let us pray. Loving God, as a people of faith, we confess that we have not always followed in your path. We declare that we have hope and faith in you, but at times, hearts touched and despaired. We are called to share your gift of love, but at times we have hoarded your gifts for our benefit. Loving God, we pray that as you journey with us, you will set us on your path, free us from the power of distraction, biases, and prejudice in this world that is separate from you. Amen. And this is a time, it's always a tough moment, when God, during this time, we are called to confess to things that we're not proud of. Before we go any further in the worship, before you are required to revive your word of hope, before you attempt to weave love into our lives, before we make our commitment, we are called to turn to you in all honesty and lay our sins at your feet. Be with us now, loving Creator, and fill us with the courage and remind us to trust that your forgiving power as we pray. This is the time for silent prayer. And God hears the words not uttered on our lips, but rest on our hearts. Members of the body of Christ, once more we have shared the mystery of grace, and we are reborn, free from the world's limitations. Our hearts are open to God's presence, and we are reminded once again that we are God's beloved children, and we are called to share God's blessings with others. Amen. Is that amen? Oh, I forgot. Good. Thank you. And this is the time when we present our offerings. The offerings, there's a plate at the back, and then on both ends of both doors, there's a little plate. And you're welcome to leave it there. We offer to God and ourselves as their gifts to God. Everything that we have is a gift from God. We give in response to God's generosity, as a sign of our commitment to serve Christ with our whole lives. The money given today, received by e-transfer or automatic bank withdrawals, by cash or check, can be symbols of the gifts that we give of our time, possession, and how we care for others. They're only symbols. And feel free to drop it off on the way out, on the way in, or to give your gifts of the Spirit. And our offertory hymn is Spirit of the Living God, 376.
Thank you.
center is God, whose gifts know no boundaries. We work in us to remove the limits of our love. Bless this offering that it may bring to those who have been repelled as untouchable, rejected as undeserving, and dismissed as incomprehensible. Expand our love and our offering so that others may experience your love in a world that we may serve you in our lives. Amen. And young at heart, amen, amen. Whoa, this will be fun. So, the kids can go downstairs if they like. Joellen's got some stuff happening down there. I know she's got some coloring. When I went to Guns Hill Cheese, did I say that right? Gun Hill's Cheese? Yep. I got a wonderful swag bag. I got this, and inside was a beautiful picture of a cow resembling the cow here. And it's on a triangle, so I know that they made copies of that for coloring. And I know that Joellen's got some other things. She's a pretty nice lady. You don't need to be afraid of her. So, does anybody know this song? I'm just curious. I want to go. That's okay. I like little kids. We have a daycare next door, and sometimes they make lots of noise, and I love it. Between 11:30 and about 1 o'clock when they go for their naps, it is total uproar. They're crying, they're screaming, they're eating their lunch. It's all let loose, and I get a lot accomplished. It's nice. So the song I want to talk about today is... I learned this song from a cute neighbor. We moved into town when I was 13, and there was a couple of cute boys that lived down the street. Very cute boys, yes siree. Played guitar, one had a band later on, an artist. Oh, my heart. Obviously, I'm straight, but I don't hate. Anyway, these boys were just... So, the one boy taught me a song, and no one has ever heard it before, and I'm hoping that maybe someone here might know it. Isn't life wonderful? Isn't life gay? Isn't life a nice way to pass the time away? Okay, so I didn't sing it that well, but nothing? When I was young, I thought the one boy was really into the Beatles. The Beatles were still together then, and I could take them or leave them. I know, don't hit me, don't hate me. I have learned since in my wisdom of old age to appreciate them. But for years, I thought it was some obscure Beatles song, as if there is such a thing as an obscure Beatles song. But that's what I thought. So then I learned, you know, as once you hit my generation, you don't automatically just look things up on the internet. Oh, I don't know that. Let's look it up on the internet. I don't go there automatically. But one time I did, I looked up a game that we used to play in the schoolyard and said, I'm going out to smoke my pipe, but I won't be back to Saturday night, and don't let the witch in. Anybody ever hear of that? Apparently, there is a whole site committed to this game. And there was all kinds of rules, and as I'm reading, it all started coming back. And I thought, this was inspiring. We weren't strange after all. And then I thought, aha, I'll look up this song that my friend taught me. And I looked it up, and sure enough, there it was. Now get this. It was an old vaudeville tune sung back during vaudeville, turn of the century, celebrating the gay, queer lifestyle that was under the radar at that time. and this was one of their songs. And I don't know whether it was code for something, it seemed, but I tried to bring, I lost my internet today. I went to print off my sermon, and I was going to double check on this little say, but no power, I lost the power is what I lost. And I couldn't print off my sermon, couldn't look things up on the internet. So if anybody wants to look it up, feel free, not during the service, because I'm totally brilliant, I don't want you to miss it. But I think it's fun. The song that I have been singing for the past 50 plus years has been an ally. I think I can I call myself an ally? Is that okay? Am I allowed? Yay!
We love you.
I love you too. Thank you, thank you. There, I heard a saying that someone said on a t-shirt, be careful who you hate. It could be someone you love. And I think that that speaks volumes. So where are we now? Oh, my love colors outside the lines. Now I know that the majority of you will not know this song. But look at the words and enjoy the words because it's truly beautiful. There's a line in there that says, you'll never walk on water if you're not afraid to drown. It's like walking on the other side of things, stepping out from the norm and embracing it. So let's all join together and we get to stand. The choir will let us know when. We can sing My Love Colors Outside the Lines. Bless their hearts, I appreciate it. So, unless you want to sing with us, which is totally allowed. You ready?
Yes, I'm ready. So the two scripture readings today will be taken from the Inclusive Bible, which I didn't even know existed till I came back to this church after a few years' absence. It was printed in 2007, and so it's inclusive. They were looking at language that was racist at that time, and also to be inclusive of women. And so there's a story about it, and a lot of people got together and did to see how they translate Bibles, right? But the one thing I found interesting was a little story down here about the word prostitute. And the way the word prostitute was translated, it's always translated as prostitute. And not always, often, almost always, we think of women as prostitutes, right? And so when they discovered that the word that they were using at that time, when it was written, that actually meant idolater. Very different word than what we think of as prostitute, isn't it? So they changed that word in a lot of the areas to idolater and not prostitute. And so it's not so sexist, right? Because, so I thought that was interesting. They did that for a lot of words in this particular translation of the Bible. And so, I thought that was very interesting to know about that. So I'm reading from the book of Matthew, it's chapter 22, and it starts at verse 34 and goes to verse 40. When the Pharisees heard that Jesus had left the Sadducees speechless, they gathered together, and one of them, an expert on the law, attempted to trick Jesus with this question: "Teacher, what commandment of the law is the greatest?" Jesus answered, "You must love the Most High God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. That is the greatest and first commandment. The second is like it. You must love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments, the whole law is based, and the prophets as well."
last month, but they came in early, so thank you. I appreciate it. Isn't it a lovely song?
So I just realized that my wife stole my flag, so I'll show you my suspender. Except you can get these at Walmart apparently, but the package says 14 plus, but it's wrong. They're only meant for 14-year-olds. They're certainly not meant for 6'2" adults. My name is Neil Bolson, and I'd like to read the second scripture reading taken from 1 Corinthians chapter 13. And if you've been at a wedding anywhere in the world, you may have heard some of these words. Even if I can speak in all the tongues of earth, and those of the angels too, but do not have love, I am just a noisy gong, a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy, such that I can comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, or if I have faith great enough to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own to feed those poorer than I, then hand over my body to be burned, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not jealous. It does not put on airs, and it is not snobbish. It is never rude or self-seeking. It is not prone to anger, nor does it brood over injuries. Love doesn't rejoice in what is wrong, but rejoices in the truth. There is no limit to love's forbearance, to its trust, its hope, its power to endure. Love never fails. Prophecies will cease. Tongues will be silent. Knowledge will pass away. Our knowledge is imperfect, and our prophesying is imperfect. When the perfect comes, the imperfect will pass away. When I was a child, I used to speak like a child, think like a child, reason like a child. But when I became an adult, I put childish ways aside. Now we see indistinctly, as in a mirror. Then we will see face to face. My knowledge is imperfect now. Then I will know even as I am known. There are in the end three things that last: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love.
So now we come to the sermon. And I promise I'll have you out of here by 11:30. That means I got 12 minutes in which to do everything, including the closing. So you're not going to get a 12-minute sermon. Praise God. And like I said, my computer, the hydro went off just as I was printing off everything, and the computer did not print off my sermon. So let's see what I can remember. I think we better pray. Loving God, thank you for the opportunity to come together in this sacred house. We ask now that the words that I speak and those that listen will find acceptance and grace in you. Amen. Drink of water. Amen. Amen, amen. I could just do this all day. I've had a song, not only what the world needs now, and there's been a few songs running through my head this week, and we get to hear another one at the ending, Somewhere Over the Rainbow has always been a favorite of mine. And today, it's been, well, really is a Beatles tune, and I just went blank. Love, all you need is love. Da 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 ba ba. All you need is love. Love. All you need is love. That's been in my head. And I think that if life could be that simple, life would be much easier. Unfortunately, since the dawn of time, humanity has tried to find ways to separate. I don't know why. Perhaps back then it was a mean of survival. But I think today we should know better. We should have learned by now. When I was a little girl, one of my favorite part of Saturday mornings, we had chores on Saturday morning, and the final chore was, this is back when the mail was still delivered on Saturday, I would go out to the mailbox, get the mail, which would include on Saturday the Life magazine. Who remembers the Life magazine? Had a big influence on my life, huge picture magazine. And it was there every week that the news came to the country. And I watched the civil rights movement unfold within those black and white photos. I learned about history, most of it American. But I saw they did a whole magazine thing on issue on the city of Pompeii. This is how young I was. I couldn't sleep that night because I was afraid a volcano would take me up. And I came down to my mom in the kitchen. She was working. I think she was doing laundry, one of those little spin cycle thingies. And she said to me with a very impatient voice, if you can't be any wiser than that, then maybe you're too young to be reading the Life magazine. I ran and never complained again about anything I read in the Life magazine. But it was there that we watched the civil rights, and I remember as a little girl thinking that at this point in my life, there would be no more need to march, to protest, that at this point, the society would have it figured out. And it breaks my heart that we haven't. It truly breaks my heart that we haven't figured it out. I don't know what the answer is. The same book that was read from this morning, they find reasons to hate. And hate takes up this enormous space, and it feels overwhelming. And it's heavy and it's oppressive. When I was a little girl, I would watch, as I said, the civil rights, and I was so thankful that I wasn't black. There was a beautiful picture of this young girl, Ruby, her last name's gone from me. Like I said, I couldn't print off the service. And she walked into the schools to break segregation. We've all seen those pictures of this beautiful little girl with her hair in braids and a beautiful clean white dress. And I would look at that, and her back is straight. And she's looking straight ahead. And all around her are these faces that reminded me of my family, my aunts and my uncles, my family around the table, but with expressions of hate that I had never witnessed before. And it frightened me. And I was so thankful I wasn't black, because I didn't know if I would ever be that brave. Could I be that courageous? And today I salute you, because I don't know if I could be so brave. I learned this week that the reason pride, this is how oblivious I am, that Pride Month is held in June because this is when, after the Stonewall, did I say it right? Stonewall arrest and riots began, was in the month of June. It was the first time the community said enough. We are worthy. We deserve more. We're not going to take it anymore. I'm sorry that it's still happening. You deserve better. We are all creations of God. God created each and every one of us. We are stardust. Each one of us come from the same stars. And we are loved and we are worthy. Each one of us is special. And it is when we embrace that spirit that created you that you can rise up and to be and to celebrate all that God created you to be. And that includes how you dress, how you look, how you love. That nothing should stop you from embracing and shining and glowing and sparkling. You are worthy. We're down to 3 minutes. Our next hymn is about who is my mother, who is my father. And that we are all gathered and we are one spirit in Christ. And that we are, that God loves us and sees no differences. When God created the earth, he created us. Not that I'm a creationist. But the legend has it, the scripture tells us that we are created for relationship. At the time when the creation stories were written, so many of them were violent in that corner of the world. But our creation story is peaceful and loving. And God wants a relationship with you. And don't worry, God loves you just the way you are. I saw a quote the other day, the Lord is my shepherd and he knows I'm gay. So let us rejoice and join together as we sing, Who is My Mother? And again, you may not know the words of, but pay attention to the words.
Your love is tied to that grace.
that we do not need to be afraid to come to you, that you will love us and hold us and understand who we are. We thank you for the opportunity to come together this day to worship in this sacred space where we are all siblings to you, our loving Creator. We pray for those who are hurting. We pray for those who are carrying the weight of pain and unhealed injuries and grievances, that they may find healing in your love. We ask for understanding. We pray for patience. We pray for knowledge. We pray for the hurt to be healed. We pray for love, that we will understand that each one of us is worthy and that nothing can separate us from your love. We pray all these things and so much more in the name of your Son, who taught us to pray together these words: Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever
and ever.
Amen.
Okay, so one more thing. I'm going to be doing the commissioning and benediction in a moment. There is a lunch downstairs, so I'm going to say grace too. And our closing, we have a special guest quartet that are going to come in for our closing of singing Somewhere Over the Rainbow. So thank you, ladies. And that'll be great. So I'm going to say the commissioning and benediction, then I'm going to say grace, and then the ladies are going to sing. And then we're made to depart. So, commissioning. God, it is responsive. Did I put it in? I didn't put it in. Okay, so I'll say both parts. God calls us a beloved. We go to what God loves. Accept your calling to love, to heal, to seek justice, and to reconcile. We answer God's call in all that we say and all that we do. The courage of Christ attend you, the love of God surround you, and the Spirit guide you. Amen. Loving Creator, we thank you for the opportunity to join down two stairs together to break bread. We ask that your Spirit continue to be with us as we join together in your name. Amen. And ladies,